Here we are reading about the Tariff of Abominations. And the Tariff of Abominations was a targeted tax on the South. It became law May 19th, 1828. The Tariff of Abominations was the name outraged Southerners gave to a tariff passed in 1828. Remember, a tariff is a tax on foreign goods. Residents of the South believed that the tax on imports was excessive and unfairly targeted specifically their part of the country, their region of the country. It has also been called the Tariff of 1828 because it's a tariff. It's in 1828. Tariffs are taxes imposed on imports designed to raise their prices. This would make them less attractive to customers, thus protecting domestic industries from foreign competition. I mean, if we have a tariff in the United States, it makes other people's goods artificially expensive and our goods look cheaper, so people buy more of our stuff. The tariff, which became law in the spring of 1828, set very high duties, taxes, on goods imported from the United States. And by doing so, it did create major economic problems for the South. The South was not a manufacturing center. It had to either import finished goods from Europe, primarily Great Britain, or buy goods made in the North. Adding insult to injury, the law had obviously been devised to protect manufacturers in the Northeast. With a protective tariff essentially creating artificially high prices, consumers in the South found it themselves at a severe disadvantage when buying products from either Northern or foreign manufacturers. See, they're saying that it's favoritism. The federal government is showing favoritism to the North. The 1828 tariff created a further problem for the South as it reduced business with England, and that in turn made it more difficult for the English to afford cotton grown in the South. Intense feelings about the Tariff of Abominations prompted John C. Calhoun to anonymously write essays setting forth his theory of nullification. Nullification in United States constitutional history. What is nullification? Well, here we go. It is a legal theory that a state has the right to nullify, or in other words, invalidate, make it go away, bad, any federal law with which that state has deemed unconstitutional with respect to the United States Constitution, as opposed to the state's own constitution. Calhoun's protest against the federal government eventually led to the nullification crisis. The Tariff of Abominations did not lead to any extreme actions, such as secession by the state of South Carolina. The Tariff of 1828 greatly increased resentment toward the North, a feeling which persisted for decades and helped lead the nation toward civil war. So the Tariff of Abominations is one of the early causes of the Civil War. It's economics. And if you look at the graphic above me, you have the tariff debate of 1828. So what did the South believe was going on here? Because while the North, they simply believed that by having these tariffs, the majority of people in America would stand to make more money because the majority of people in America lived in the North. The South had a little bit more complicated look at this. They said that because of this tariff, foreign goods are made more expensive. This would mean that people buy more U.S. goods. Those are made in the North. European countries would retaliate by buying less Southern cotton, meaning the South loses money. To make the European countries happy again, the South would buy European manufactured goods even though they were more expensive than the ones from the North. All in all, the only people to actually lose any money in all of this would be the Southern states, which is why they were so angry about it. They don't like losing money. Nobody likes losing money, especially whenever you're like, look, the guys up North, they're making all this money, and it's specifically targeted. That's their point of view. But that point of view is the point of view that causes the South later on to feel justified when they secede and start the Civil War. So I hope you're learning, and I hope you're having fun.